What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes, with
Jose. I have to give you a nickname.
Jose needs a nickname, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, we are on our way to our next service call in the incorporated village of Stewart Manor, which is in Nassau County on Long Island in the great state of New York. Can you sense my sarcasm? All right, let's go see. They have a Williamson gas-fired boiler that's making some noises, so let's go see what's going on.
Timer flashed 7 times.
BTU system.
You ain't testing. You're guessing.
All right, so here we are. Williamson gas-fired furnace. Gas-fired furnace. I just really called it a gas-fired furnace. You know that? Gas-fired steam boiler. Customer's immediate complaint is that the banging sound, it sounds like, quote unquote, someone's taking a hammer and slamming the pipes with it. So we have Jose. He is, looks like he's draining water. Jose, may I ask you a question? You're draining water, right?
So, yes.
Okay, why? May I ask why?
It looks like the sight glass is way past the fuel level.
Okay.
So, but it could just be dirty also.
Okay.
So we're going to have to take that out, clean it out, so we can gauge the correct water level.
Okay. So what's your first step going to be right now? That's your first step? Okay, what's your second step?
Empty the bucket.
Okay.
Come back. And then close the valves. And then take out the sight glass.
Okay, you could do that.
Yep. All right, you know, they say, you know, boiler installations is like a work of art. Everyone is different. Here, every technician's approach will be different. Because of the intensity of the water coming out of this boiler, my first priority would be to drain it until there's nothing left, or and then see if there's any water level in that sight glass. But everyone's approach is different.
All right, so.
Again, it's my first boiler.
So understood. So the homeowner has manually added water by pushing in the red button on the automatic feeder because there's not a bypass valve on this. Also, keep in mind the good future note is that the boiler is being fed with cold water, not hot water, and it should be fed with hot water. But nonetheless, there's no bypass valve there. So it appears that we have a full sight glass, but Jose would like to check it and clean it, which is fine because it may be dirty. But when you open up that valve with the bucket under it, the intensity of water comes out there is like there's pressure, right? We can also open up that relief valve right there and see if there's any water comes out of it, right?
Yep.
Let's see what happens. So let's put that bucket right there. Open up that relief valve.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Okay. So we don't have a completely flooded boiler, but we do have what appears to be dirty sight glass and or an excessively filled boiler. All right, so Jose is going to get the 5-gallon bucket from the truck. While he's doing that, I'm going to utilize the customer's bucket for now and keep an eye on the sight glass. I'm going to make sure that these are not fully open, but they're backed out a little bit. And that water's filthy, by the way. And just waiting. So let's guess. We already did one bucket. How many more buckets do you think we're going to need of this size bucket? I'm going to guess, say, 2 more. That's my guess. All right, manually filling. And we're just flushing out the bottom drain valve. Kind of like skimming the boiler, but we're skimming all that crap off the top of the boiler. Get all that cocky out of that valve. And then reinstall the clean sight glass. All right. I would let it fill automatically so we could test that. All right, so we flushed out the bottom drain with the bottom valve on the sight glass. Our water's still kind of dirty. We'll give them a little schooling on the temperature of boiling water that's dirty versus clean water and how it affects his wallet. Nonetheless, we're going to have a call for autofill on the boiler. No, because we have adequate water. Okay. So now, the customer's complaint is excessive banging every time the boiler kicks on. Okay. Pop quiz. What's the banging sound?
Water in the pipes.
Okay. And why does it bang?
Usually if there's water in the line that doesn't come back from the wet return, that will make the
okay. Bang. Yep. Simplified answer. Water where it shouldn't be and steam hits it, it's traveling 45 miles an hour and violently explodes. Okay. Do a visual inspection of the system and the piping. And if you need a torpedo, there's one in my tool bag. But determine what we see is anything. Determine if there's anything visible that can cause that. So, ladies and gentlemen, steam is a very, very, very simple, yet could be complex system. It was also a premium heating system that was installed at the turn of the century and also in the mid 20th century in homes that were being built. You know, we had a massive building boom in the United States, especially the Northeast, where you had a lot of returning veterans from World War II, for example, and they needed homes. And Long Island, where we are, you had farmland that all of a sudden became neighborhoods and towns and communities. So the upgrade from a forced air system, which was basically a gravity furnace generally at the time, sitting in the center of the house in the basement, an upgrade to that, you know, was hydronic and also steam. You know, steam was the first type of heating system rather than forced air, to my knowledge, in a residential setting. It was an upgrade. You know, if you look at all these pipes here, right? Every single pipe was threaded by hand. You know, a man put this together by hand. There was no machine. There was no rigid threading machine that would cut the pipe and then you have an apprentice put it together. No, it was all done by hand with a threader, manual threader, and oiler. And you best believe, right, if I paid a premium of a couple hundred dollars for a steam system in my brand new home, that it was quiet. You best believe it was quiet. And if it wasn't quiet, oh man, it'd be holy hell, right? If I just paid $4,000 for this brand new house, right? Back in 1930, 1920, 1940, 50, right? You best believe it was quiet every single night because a happy wife is a happy life. But what happened is over time, you know, you have people who don't really know steam working on it and run into problems, right? Like banging sounds we are here now. Now, I'm going to give Jose an opportunity to figure out what's going on. One of the first things I noticed, and as a good technician, I'm observing my surroundings. You take a look at all the steam piping. There's something lacking. Okay? That's a hint. Okay? So keep watching and you're gonna see with your own eyes.
Okay, Jose.
I think this wet return right here, it doesn't have a good pitch. It's parallel.
You think it doesn't have a good pitch. Okay. Wrong. It's a wet return. It's water. It's being returned to the boiler by gravity. So, not the answer. And steam is not down there. Okay. Steam could never be down there. Okay. Ever. If it was a brand new system with no water in it, you wouldn't have steam. Gotcha. Okay? Try again. You told me before, the cause, correctly and accurately, the cause of banging sounds like... like that. If we go upstairs right now and ask them, is that what you hear? They're going to say, yes, that was. Right? So you accurately answered the question. Here's the black thing back. Just don't put it in your mouth because it's been in my mouth. Oh. I like black things in my mouth that illuminate. Sorry. You answered the question before, right? The hammering sound on a steam system is caused by water violently exploding when steam traveling at around 45 miles an hour hits it, right? At low pressure. Pressure equals temperature equals pressure and also velocity, right? So, water, picture you're traveling inside these pipes, right? What's the first thing that comes to mind? Why is she calling me? I already told the Brooklyn Nets that I don't want VIP, section 9, row 5, center court, half season, season B at the New York Nets for this year. I already told her that. Even though it includes Qatar access and includes VIP access, you know, entry. I told her not this year, but she keeps hounding me. Say, look at this. She keeps calling me. Stop. Leave me alone, Nikki. Maybe she wants a pipe.
And the money.
Maybe. And the money. She definitely wants the money. Okay. So picture your steam, right? But let's take a look at the piping, okay? I always say a good technician is observant of his surroundings. What? Tell me about the piping. Tell me what you see, what you don't see, and we'll go from there. Tell me what you see and what you don't see.
I mean, I've seen that these are usually piped up higher. They have a
higher... Okay. Yeah, right. But there's a minimum, and it's usually 18 inches off top of the boiler. And you're at that. Okay? Keep going. Okay. Let's just stand right here. Let's take things out of the equation, right? You're standing right there. Look at the boiler. Think about the boiler. Look at the piping on the boiler. Tell me what you see and what you don't see. Keep in mind, the house is probably from, you know, the 1930s, 1940s, maybe that era, right? And the house is also under renovation right now, but that may or may not be relevant. But tell me what you see and what you don't see.
It doesn't have any venting.
Okay, keep going. And I apologize if I'm putting you under pressure. But if you learn something new every day, you become that much more knowledgeable and that much more valuable. Right? Because you can never be outsourced to a call center in India.
Right. I mean, I don't see anything else besides that.
Okay. All right. So, you know, if the boiler was replaced today because of the residential energy conservation laws and residential building code, when we install a new boiler, especially steam, the piping that we work on or that we replace and remove shall be insulated. Okay. At one point of the life of this home, all of this pipe insulation, all this piping was wrapped with AeroSeal fiber asbestos steam pipe insulation.
Okay.
Now, think like water. Think like water and steam, right? Let's talk about pitch. Okay? I see we have flying pitch on this radiator line right here, right?
Yeah.
I could see that this is a high point, this is a lower point, and this gradually goes down, right? But we can put a torpedo on there and see if that's level. That's also our end line. That looks like that drops down right there, and that becomes our wet return, which is here, right? So let's put a level on this. Let's check that first.
Where did you say the torpedo was?
That's in there, a little silver thing. Ticking right there, all right? So shove that onto that pipe, and let's see if we got some pitch. Are we flying pitch in the right direction?
Nope.
We're going, looks like we're going uphill there.
Yep.
And we'll double check that because we're an idiot. There we go. So that is, see, we have, it goes down here a little bit, but then here.
It flattens out.
Here it looks like it is slightly, there's a bow in this pipe. If you look right there, there's a bow right there. And that's the low point, that coupling.
Yep.
Okay. Now, I didn't notice this before, but I noticed this before. I checked this out. We have flying pitch there. Right? Now, let's go to the other side of this wall. Let's turn on this light. Okay? And here is that line again. We have flying pitch right there. Okay? And here's more of that. We even have a bracing right there. Right? See that? And here we have, it looks like it, oh, hold on. We are pitched that way slightly. And let's take a look at this. This is our wet return or dry return. And we are pitched right here. This becomes a trap of water. And guess what happened here, ladies and gentlemen? At one point, this pipe, this 2-inch pipe, was wrapped with AeroSeal asbestos steam pipe insulation, which created, I would say, maybe 3/4 inch of gap between this piece of nailer, which looks like it's broken. Looks like it was much higher at one point. Actually, it's not even doing anything anymore, ladies and gentlemen. See, uncut, unedited, raw. But, and then when they cleaned up, they put some kind of treatment paint on this piping after they removed the asbestos, and that was it. And they called it a day. But all of the piping here is not properly pitched. All right? And that's the reason why they have the banging sounds, and that is the reason why we're here.